So this is the chemistry class number 53. So and we are continuing the reactions of halogens actually. So today these are the reactions of halogens with metals. You see, generally halogens react with the metals with the X2, that is M, or you write M plus X2. Let us say M plus X2. You will get MX2. This is one type of halides, you see, metal halides. Another type of metal halides are M2 plus X2, gives to 2MX. M2 plus X2 gives what? 2MX. So metals and non-metals, you can take metals as well as non-metals. So therefore reactions of halogens with metals and non-metals, that is, both will react. So therefore, so generally MX2 and MX2, you see. So metal halides, these are of two types. For example, you see, so that is Mg plus Cl2, you will get MgCl2. So this is this is divalent metal, you see. This is divalent metal, of course. If you take this type of example, 2Na plus Cl2, you will get 2NaCl. So and then that is 4Al plus 3Cl2, you will get 2AL plus 3Cl2, 2AL Cl3. So this is a trivalent metal, you see. It is trivalent. That is the MX2 means, you see, it is not come under this definition, of course. So if you take that is 2Ca plus Cl2, 2CaCl2, Cl2, like this. So this is how we can have many number of examples. So halogens react with metals and non-metals, forming their respective halides, metal halides and metallic non-metallic halides. Metallic halides as well as what? Non-metallic halides. For example, Sn plus Cl2, SnCl2, Hg plus Cl2, HgCl2, HgCl2. Like this, you see, you will be getting different types of metals, metallic halides as well as non-metallic halides. So after this, you see, and what is the ionic character of these metal halides, you see? That is, ionic character, if you take ionic character of all these metals, if you take characters, generally ionic character decreases down the group. So that means decreases from, let us say, that is HF to HI, let us say. That is MF, metallic fluoride to metallic iodide. So that is MF greater than that is MCl greater than MBr greater than MI. So subject to the condition that you see, so M is equal to monovalent. M is equal to what? Monovalent. Monovalent. So that is how we can explain the ionic characters of these metallic halides, you see. Metallic lattice ionic character of metallic halides decreases down the group. Therefore, you see, so that is MF greater than MCl, greater than MBr, greater than what? MI. So metallic fluoride greater than metallic chloride, metallic chloride, metallic what? Iodide. So down the group. So this is how we can explain the ionic character also for this metallic halides. So after that, one more reaction of halogens is. So that is reaction of halogens with other halogens, with other halogens. What is the meaning of this, you see? So let me know the reaction of halogens with other halogens. Halogen react with other halogen, let us say. So that means X react with another X. Okay, that means you see, here one halogen reacts with another halogen. You will be getting the products of what the interhalogens. What are the products formed when one halogen reacts with another halogen? The products formed are called the what? Interhalogens. Interhalogens. Having the formula, having the general formula, that is X X dash 7. So that means you see, this is how we can explain the different types of interhalogens. So the substituting condition that you see, for example, you see, so that is CLF3 and then IF7, like this you see. So that is chlorine trifluoride, iodine heptafluoride. Okay, so that means here you see X is equal to what is X and what is X dash you see. X is equal to that is your larger halogen atom. Halogen atom. X dash is equal to smaller halogen atom. So that means, for example, if you take the IF7 and then so CLF6, CLF5, or that is BRF3. So here, so this is X, this is X. That means X is equal to larger halogen. So that is iodine is larger than fluorine. Chlorine is larger than fluorine. So bromine is larger than fluorine. Like that you see, X is larger halogen atom. X dash is equal to smaller halogen atom. So X is equal to larger halogen atom. X dash is equal to smaller halogen atom. So therefore, XX dash 3, XX dash 5, XX dash 7. So this is how we will be getting different types of interhalogen compounds. Let us say, what are interhalogen compounds? These are the compounds which are obtained by the reaction of halogens with other halogens. With what? Other halogens. So having the general formula XX dash 3, XX dash 5, XX dash 7. So this is how we can explain the formation of interhalogen also here. Okay. So after this interhalogen compound you see. So that completes actually the reactions of halogens, reactions of chemical properties of halogens. You see, so after that we will start one more topic, that is called the chlorine. You see, chlorine. In the halogen, we have to study two concepts: one chlorine preparation properties, and then hydrogen chloride HCl preparation properties. Okay. So here chlorine, you see, this is chlorine, the gas. You know that you see. So this chlorine is a gas which is prepared by different methods. You see, chlorine can be prepared by different methods. So we know that you see by, for example, preparation of chlorine, preparation of chlorine. So first method, let me take this electrolysis of brine. You see, you know what is electrolysis of brine? Brine or brine, that is nothing but NaCl solution. So that is NaCl solution is called as the brine solution or brine solution. You see, electrons of brine, that is sodium chloride. So first and foremost ionization is created in Na plus ion and electron Cl minus ion. In the aqueous medium, you see, aqueous medium, and then after electron passing electric current, you see, so at anode, what happens? So that is 2 Cl minus 2 electrons give rise to Cl2. Yes. At cathode, this is, that is sodium, that is Na plus one electron give rise to Na. So that means you see, on passing electric current through the brine solution, it undergoes electrolysis. So where chlorine gas liberates at anode, and the sodium is formed at the or discharged at the water cathode. So that is how the chlorine can be prepared. That is one method. So let me take one more method, second method. See, so from potassium permanganate, what is the formula for potassium permanganate? That is KMnO4. You know that this is potassium permanganate solution. So crystals are dark crystals, you see, dark brown crystals, let us say. So but when they are put in water, you will be getting a pink colored solution. You see, What is the color of the solution we are going to get? Pink color solution. So therefore, when potassium permanganate is added, the crystals are added with concentrated hydrochloric acid. That is, KMnO4 is added with a, that is a HCl hydrochloric acid. That is concentrated HCl. You will be getting the chlorine gases liberated. For the balancing the chemical equation, you can put 2 here, this is 16, you see. So then you will be getting the, that is 2KCl actually, that is 2KCl plus 2MnCl2 plus 16, that means 8H2O, 8H2O plus 5Cl2. So that means Cl, 2Cl plus 2, 4Cl. Is 6Cl, 6Cl plus 10Cl is 16Cl, that means HCl. So that is how when potassium permanganate crystals are made to react with concentrated hydrochloric acid, you are going to get chlorine gas. You know that, you see, chlorine gas is 5 to 6 times heavier than your air, you see, air. And it is easily soluble in water, of course. We know that point. So this is one method. First method is from that is electrolysis of a brine solution. Second method from potassium permanganate, we can prepare the chlorine gas. So next, third method is. So from, that is from, that is manganese dioxide. What is the formula for manganese dioxide? MnO. So when manganese dioxide is made to react with the hydrochloric acid again, that is MnO2 plus 4HCl, you have to put this, 4HCl. So this is a manganese dioxide, MnO2. This is 4HCl, of course this is concentrated. So therefore you can write as you get MnCl2, you see. What is that? MnCl2, manganese chloride. And then 4H means 2H2O, you can write, that is 2H2O. And 4Cl means that is another Cl2, chloride gas. That means 4Cl, here 2Cl, here. So that is how you can balance the chemical equation, is known. We know. So that means, you see, manganese dioxide reacts with concentrated hydrochloric acid, liberating chlorine gas. So that is by the action of, that is manganese dioxide and concentrated hydrochloric acid, we will be getting manganese chloride, water, as well as what? Chlorine gas. So this is how, this is third method. So first method is by electrolysis of brine solution, second method from potassium permanganate, third method from manganese dioxide. What is that? Manganese dioxide, MnO. Fourth method from your that is a common salt, you see, common salt. We can write the common salt equation also here. Yeah. So that is from number four, from common salt. Common salt. What is the formula for common salt? That is what? NaCl. So when sodium chloride is made to react with sulfuric acid and manganese dioxide, yeah. What is the formula for that is your common salt? Sodium chloride. When sodium chloride reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid and manganese dioxide, you will be getting your chlorine gas. How actually? So that is 4NaCl plus 4H2SO4 to balance the chemical equation and MnO2. You can write that is 4NaHSO4 plus MnCl2 plus Cl2 plus 2H2O, sorry, 2H2O minus 2H2O plus Cl2. So that is, we can write this heating symbol also. That means when sodium chloride, that is part of the common salt, is made to react with concentrated sulfuric acid by adding a little potassium, sorry, manganese dioxide. So the reaction takes place between sodium chloride, sulfuric acid, and manganese dioxide, and you will get it. So that is chlorine gas is formed. So this is the fourth method. That is, first method is electrolysis of brine solution. Second method is by from KMnO4. Third method is from your manganese dioxide. Fourth method is your common salt, that is NaCl. So this is how we can prepare many number, that is a chloric gas by many number of methods. So even one more method is there, which is from the Dickens method. Dickens method. In the Dickens method, we are going to it is from oxidation actually. Dickens method. It is by oxidation. That is hydrochloric acid, you see. Hydrochloric acid undergoes oxidation, that is HCl. Undergoes oxidation O2 in presence of cupric chloride CuCl2 at 723 Kelvin, of course. So it is 4HCl plus 4O. Then you will get 4H plus 2H2. That means you are getting 2H2O out and 2Cl2 will be getting 2Cl2. That means you see, when hydrochloric acid undergoes oxidation by atmospheric oxidation with oxygen, it will have CuCl to catalyst at 723 Kelvin. So that means the hydrochloric acid undergoes oxidation, liberating water.
This is one method. This is how from 5 different methods we can prepare the chlorine gas. Okay, so that means preparation of chlorine by all these methods are over. That is 5 methods. You see, after the preparation of chlorine, let us write or let us know some of the reactions of chlorine, properties of chlorine. Properties of chlorine, you see, that is properties of chlorine.
In the properties of chlorine, you see, we already know that, you see, chlorine gas is easily soluble in water and it boils at about 239 Kelvin. That is easily soluble in water. It is easily soluble in water and boils at 239 Kelvin. After that, you see, reaction of that is chlorine with metals and non-metals. Reaction with metals, that is the reaction with metals and non-metals. So when chlorine reacts with metals and non-metals, it gives their respective metallic chlorides and non-metallic chlorides. Metallic chlorides and what? Non-metallic chlorides. So example, you see, sodium, that is 2NA plus Cl2, will get it 2NA Cl, and then 2Mg plus Cl2, will get it 2Mg Cl2 is the chloride. Okay. And aluminium, that is 2Al plus 3Cl2, you get 2Al Cl3. Okay. And even if you take phosphorus, you see, P4, that is 6Cl3, 4PCl3, phosphorus trichloride, P4 plus 6Cl2, 12Cl, 4Cl, 12Cl, you can balance that equation also. Sa, that is sulfur, in the form of 8 molecules, SA molecules, okay, SA plus 4Cl2. So you will be getting, that is 4S2Cl2. 4S2Cl2. S8 means 4 to the 8, 4 to the 8Cl, 4 to the 8. Dichlorine, disulfide. So this is how the metals and non-metals react with each other. Metals and non-metals react with the chlorine forming their respective metallic chlorides and non-metallic chlorides. So that is the explanation, and you can write some examples also. Sodium, magnesium, aluminum, like that. Okay. So after that, after the reaction with the metals and non-metals, let us take the reaction of chlorine with compounds containing hydrogen. Reaction with compounds containing hydrogen. Compounds containing hydrogen. So how this chlorine reacts with hydrogen? Compounds containing hydrogen, not hydrogen, compounds containing hydrogen. Actually, we know that, you see, so chlorine has a great affinity for hydrogen. So that means it is always seeking for hydrogen, you see, from their compounds. So therefore, if you take that, some compounds like, that is C10H16, C10 what? H16. So then if you have plus 8Cl3, so then it will react with the hydrogen, you see. That is 8 to the, how much? 16. 16H16Cl, that is 16HCl. Hydrogen chloride is obtained. Remaining is 10 tons of carbon, that is coke, you see, this carbon is nothing but what, coke. So that means the chlorine displaces the hydrogen from their compounds, you see, from their organic compounds, that is with the compounds containing the hydrogen. So the chlorine displaces the hydrogen from their compounds, so forming hydrogen chloride, forming what? Hydrogen chloride. That is one example, of course. After that, let me write the reaction with excess of chlorine is. So this excess of ammonia, excess of ammonia, this reaction is very very important for the purpose of our examination. You see,
how does that is the chlorine react
with the excess of ammonia? You see, not excess of chlorine.
How does chlorine react with the excess of ammonia? That means you see, you have to take excess of ammonia, little amount of chlorine.
What is the reaction of chlorine with excess of ammonia? What is meant? What is the that is meaning of this? You see, the how does chlorine react with excess of ammonia? That means you have to take excess of ammonia and little of chlorine. So that is the reaction. So here you see, excess of ammonia means I am going to write 8 NH3 for balance in the chemical equation. 8 NH3 plus that is a 3 Cl. So in 8 N, remove 2 hydrogen atoms. Sorry, nitrogen atoms. As N2 is plus N2. Remaining is 6N, you see. 6N. Therefore, you write 6NH4Cl. It will be, that is balanced, of course, now. So, actually, you see, 6N plus 2N, 8N. You see, 8N. 8 3s are 24H. 8 3s are 24H. 6 4s are 24H, you see. That is how you can balance the equation. That means, when excess of ammonia reacts with the chlorine, so it forms a dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. Dense white fumes, you see. Fumes of ammonium chloride. So this compound is called what? Ammonium chloride. So this is the test we are that is performing. This is the test we are performing the performing in the practical class. You see, practical class. So that means for the that is for testing the Cl minus ion. You see, and the ammonia actually. So that means when ammonium salts are for example, ammonium chloride salt is that is heated with that is added with sodium hydroxide and is heated, so that smell of ammonia is obtained. So when this test tube is added with the excess of chlorine, little chlorine gas, you see, so dense white fumes are liberated from the that is your test tube. So that is nothing but excess of ammonia. That is excess of ammonia with little chlorine. You see, you have to write excess here. Excess of ammonia. Excess of ammonia. So if you take the excess of chlorine, what happens? Excess of chlorine. So that is, this is with excess of ammonia. So excess of chlorine means, you see, with the let me complete this excess of chlorine, that is HNO3, chlorine. So this question is also very very important. You see, this question has been asked every time in the examination. Excess of chlorine means, you see, and a little amount of ammonia, excess of chlorine. You have to take excess chlorine as well as little amount of ammonia. For that, you see, little amount means limited is NH3, and chlorine is that is 3 Cl2 you have to write. So then you get nitrogen trichloride, you are going to get NCl3 you have to write. NCl3 plus 3H2 plus 3Cl is 3HCl. So this is how we can balance the chemical equation. This is called the nitrogen trichloride. Ammonia reacts with excess of chlorine, so forming nitrogen trichloride and hydrogen chloride. This is how you can write the equation. This question has been asked in the examination 2000, that is March 2020, actually. To balance the chemical equation law, this year, you see, this question has been asked very NH plus 3Cl, use a dash plus dash DC. You have to fill NCl3 and water, 3HCl. So, this is how we can balance the chemical equations also. This question, these type of questions have been asked in the, that is complete the following chemical equations. Okay. So, this is how we can explain the excess, that is excess of ammonia, excess of chlorine. That means excess of ammonia with chlorine. Excess of chlorine with ammonia. Okay. So, we will continue in the next class, of course.